Wifey Wednesday, we're gonna try something a little different. Today we're gonna make dog treats. Yes, because even our four-legged friends like to eat well. Now, my sister-in-law got me this adorable Snoopy cookbook for Christmas, and it has tons of recipes. They're all gluten-free, soy-free, healthy, all natural, and they're so easy to make. I've made them for a lot of my friends' dogs, and no one can believe that they're actually easy to do. So today I'm gonna show you how to make them. Ready? Let's get wifed up, doggy style. Okay, first what we need is a cup and a half of the oat flour and a cup and a half of brown rice flour. You can find this in the grocery store in the specialty or organic sections. It's usually not with the regular flour. And we don't want to give those to dogs because we want to keep it gluten-free. Okay, a cup and a half of each. Then we're gonna do a half cup of mozzarella cheese. I add a half cup of cheddar as well. And then tomato paste, which is strange because dogs aren't supposed to eat tomatoes, but they can have the paste apparently. We're gonna do a half cup, which is about a half of one of these small cans. Oh, and by the way, these are pizza flavored. That's what they're supposed to taste like. And they smell delicious, and I may have tried them, and they are delicious. Okay, we're gonna put that down. We need one egg. My dogs are already over here. They know that this is about to happen. Okay, basil and oregano. We need a tablespoon of each. Okay. Fancy, right, for dogs. But you know what? This is so much more inexpensive than buying treats. They're crazy. I don't know how people get away with charging so much for bags of treats. And these you can make for $3. Okay, we've got our spices in there. Then comes the fun time, or the messy time, whichever way you look at it. We're gonna eventually add a half cup of water into this mix. First, we're gonna get in there with our hands and mix everything up until it's all combined. And while I'm doing this, I'm going to point out that I'm doing this the basic way. Let's say you don't have a nice rolling sheet, you don't have a rolling pin, that's okay. I'm showing you how to do this today on a cutting board. Just put down a little foil and lots of flour, okay? Because you'll see why, you'll need lots of flour. We're gonna slowly add in the half cup of water. Why slowly? Because this dough gets real sticky real fast, and then you end up adding more and more flour, and then you have more and more to roll and more treats, and you end up feeding the whole neighborhood. It smells really good. It smells like pizza. Okay, we're gonna add more water in there. And if yours are too dry, feel free to add more than a half cup. If you don't need the full half cup, then don't use it. Okay, now we're starting to get somewhere with this dough. Definitely one of the messiest things you can make, but I'm sure all you bakers out there already know that. I'm gonna add a little more water and just take the portion that's sticking together for now. Okay, now we've got our big ball of dough. I already have laid out a cookie sheet with some parchment paper on it and some flour on that. That just keeps things clean so that nothing's gonna stick to the cookie sheet. Okay. The book also came with this really cute bone. I'm using this muddler, drink mixer, who cares, right? Because it works. And we're just gonna slowly roll this out. You want it to be about an inch and a half thick. Now, if you roll it really thin, your treats are gonna cook faster and be crunchier. My dogs like softer treats. They're easier to chew. So I like to keep the dough a little bit on the thicker side and undercook it a bit. Press on it, and there you go. I mean, come on, how easy is that? You can make any variation, of course, foods that dogs are allowed to eat. Be sure to double check in Google before you just go throwing ingredients in. You can add things like chicken, tuna, pork. All right. As you can see, these are a little bit thicker, and I made that one a little more thin just to show you the difference in the cooking time. We're gonna cook these from 12 minutes till 20, depending on how crunchy you and your four-legged friend like them. Okay, we're gonna pop these in the oven, which is set at 350, and we let the magic happen. So I've given these about 12 minutes. We have two little dogs here who are just anxiously awaiting their arrival. Let's pull them out. see how they get nice and crunchy around the edges, be sure to let them cool off before you feed them to your dogs. And obviously, I just made a couple now. You can make the entire batch. You can also use any cookie cutter you have laying around and make different shapes. Once they cool off, let's give them a taste test. What do you think? You guys want to try these? What do you think? Do you like them? Sit down if you like them. Ooh, they're a hit. Thanks for watching. Check out the blog for the full recipe. And thanks for getting wiped up. For the full recipe, hit up the blog, thewifeykitchen.com. And thanks for watching.